Hello friends, today let's look at the problem of finding out maximum number of A's with given four keys. So the problem statement is, imagine you have a special keyboard with only the following four keys. With key 1, you can print A on screen. With key 2, you can select the complete screen, so key 2 acts as a control A. With key 3, you can copy the selection to a screen buffer, so that acts as a control C. And finally, with key 4, you can append the copied buffer to screen, so that acts as a control V. Now, if you can only press the keyboard for n times with the above 4 keys, we have to write a program to find out maximum number of A's possible. Let's look at a couple of examples to understand problem clearly. So if n is equal to 1, that is, you are allowed maximum 1 keystroke, the maximum number of A's you can get is 1. With 2 keystrokes allowed, that is, n is equal to 2, you can press A 2 times and get 2 A's. With n is equal to 7 though, that is 7 keystrokes allowed, what you can do is, you can press A 3 times, then use Ctrl A and Ctrl C to copy these 3 A's to screen buffer, and finally use Ctrl V 2 times. So this Ctrl V appends 3 A's to screen, and this Ctrl V appends 3 A's to screen. So in all, you will get 9 A's, so output should be 9. Okay, now let's look at the approach to solve this problem. As we discussed, for n is equal to 1, 2, 3, you have no option but to press key A to get maximum number of A's. Let's call function to compute maximum number of A's as f. So we'll try to find out the f of n for any value of n. Now for n is equal to 4, you can either type all 4 A's, or you can type an A and then use Ctrl A Ctrl C. I'm denoting Ctrl A Ctrl C by using star A and star C, and then use Ctrl V to copy the to append the copied A to screen. So you'll get 2 A's with this method and 4 A's with this method. So optimal solution would be 4 in this case. Similarly, you can confirm for yourself that for n is equal to 5 and 6, the maximum number of A's you can get is by typing out straight A's. From n is equal to 7 onwards, things start to get a bit interesting. So, with 7 keystrokes allowed, what we can do is type all 7 A's to get 7 as output, or note that to copy and paste the screen buffer, we require at least 3 keystrokes, that is Ctrl A, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. So what we can do is, we can type only 4 A's and then use Ctrl A, Ctrl C, and finally Ctrl V will give us another 4 A's. So that is total 8 A's. Note that what we have done is, we have used f of 4 here and appended Ctrl A, Ctrl C and f of 4 again. So that becomes 2 into f of 4. Another option we have for n is equal to 7 is just type 3 A's, A, 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 and then again use Ctrl A, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. But this time we have one more keystroke left, so we can use another Ctrl V. And because of this Ctrl A, Ctrl C, our screen buffer now has 3 A's, and using then Ctrl V's 2 times gives us total 9 A's, right? So that is f of 3 followed by Ctrl A, Ctrl C, and then again f of 3, f of 3. So in all, we have 3 into f of 3. Similarly, you can see for yourself that with 2 A's typed and then following it up with Ctrl A, Ctrl C and 3 Ctrl V's, you can get let's see, 4 into f of 2, so that will be f of 2 is 2, 8 number of a's, and for 1a following it up with control a, control c and control v sequence, you get 5 into f of 1 a's, that would be 5 a's. And because we are interested in finding out the maximum number of a's possible for a given n, maximum number would be 9 in our case. So we can say that f of 7 is 9. The thing that I wanted to illustrate from this example is that the computation involved is recursive computation. As you have seen, for f of 7, we had to use f of 4, f of 3, f of 2 and f of 1, and we actually started from n minus 3 because 3 keystrokes are required for using control A, control C and control V, and multiplier equal to 2 and keep incrementing the multiplier. So let us try and define f of n for any given n. I'll write the f of n here. So f of n is equal to n if n is less than or equal to 6, or f of n equal to max of, I'll write here, 2 into f of n minus 3, comma 3 into f of n minus 4, comma 4 into f of n minus 5, and so on and so forth, till this will go till n minus 2, because as you have seen, for n is equal to 7, our multiply went up to 5. So n minus 2 into f of 1, and we have to find the max from this set if n is greater than 6. We'll be using the exact same definition of f of n while implementing the algorithm. But before jumping onto the code, let's make sure that we all understand what the method that we discussed, and also make sure that this method works for all values of n. So method that we discussed is, we start from n minus 3 keystrokes for finding out f of n. Type n those many a's, and then follow it up with only two keystrokes of control A, control C, and then use all the keystrokes as control V's for a remaining number of keystrokes. So you might wonder that, let's say for n is equal to 14, what you can do is say type 8 A's. So I have typed 8 A's, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm still remaining with 6 keystrokes. I can do control A, control C, control V, and with the proposed method, what we are supposed to do is use all control V's in here as well. So control V, control V, control V. But you can also do a control A, control C and control V here. And I wanted to make sure that the method of using all control V's works in all cases. For that, let's jump to the next slide and see how exactly we can prove that. So here, assume that we have computed f of values of function f till n minus 1. So we already know the optimal number of a's for n minus 1 keystrokes, n minus 2 keystrokes, n minus 3 keystrokes, and so on and so forth. This is f of n minus 6. And we are interested in finding out optimal number of keystrokes for value n. So I don't know f of n, and I can use these computed subfunctions to compute f of n. Now, until f of n minus 5, f of n minus 5, I don't have any option because I am only remaining with 5 keystrokes. So I can use control A, control C combination only once, and follow it up with all control V's, right? But at n minus 6 point, that is, you just use optimal value of f of n minus 6 after n minus 6 keystrokes. You have option of using, so you have used, let's say, control A, control C, control V. You have option of using again either all three control V's here, or control A, control C, control V here. Now note that if you use control A, control C, control V here, these three keystrokes, those would be exact same as these keystrokes, control A, control C and control V. And we have already taken into consideration this part, that is f of n minus 3, and following it up with control A, control C, control V. And we also know that after n minus 3 keystrokes, this is the maximum value we can get for number of A's. So there is actually no point in using control A, control C and control V keystrokes in here. Instead, what we should do is use all control V's to see if that helps. So with this theoretical proof, what we have proved is all we need to do after n minus 3 keystrokes is use control A, control C and follow it up with all control V's. And there is no point in using control A, control C, control V. I hope the explanation was clear for this proof. Now let's jump on to the code. So find max A's is the subroutine that is supposed to compute the maximum number of A's possible for input as n, maximum keystrokes allowed, and this I am using to store the intermediate results. So if n is less than 0, that is obviously the error case. If n is less than or equal to 6, we simply return n. I'll write down the f of n just for the clarity again. F of n is equal to n if n is less than or equal to 6 and is equal to max of 2 into f of n minus 3 comma 3 into f of n minus 4, so on and so forth, n minus 2 into f of 1. We have to find the max of this if n is greater than 6, right? So if n is less than or equal to 6, we simply return n. We simply return n. And for n greater than 6, we use this for loop to implement this functionality. So we start from I is equal to n minus 3. We compute the max number of A's possible for each value of I, and then we multiply that value. So we multiply that value. This max A's solution stores the computed values and multiply that with a multiplier, which we initialize from 2 because we start from 2. Keep incrementing the multiplier, keep decrementing the value of I. Keep incrementing the multiplier 2, 3 till n minus 2, and keep decrementing the I n minus 3, n minus 4 till 1. So notice that this is 1, so it can be actually 1, but if you can confirm that, it actually doesn't make any difference, because if f of 0 we are returning as 0, and we finally need to return the max value of max value from this set. So for tracking the maximum value, we are using this if block, and finally we return this max value. The max so far value is returned if n was greater than 6. I hope the code explanation was also clear. Thank you.